Right now, one person is dead and two people are recovering after a triple shooting inside a home in Crystal Springs.
Police say shots were fired last night after 10. 16 WAPT's Crystal Hilliard has been following this story for us, and she joins us now. So do police know what happened and why this happened?
They're still trying to answer that question, but here is what they do know. They say a man named Javaris Green on his 21st birthday went into a Crystal Springs home and left with bullet wounds. Police say he was with his two cousins, 32-year-old Marcus Green and 20-year-old Christopher Green, both from Jackson. Police believe Javaris Green went into the home by himself and two people were inside, Berinda Finley and her 25-year-old son, Tamarco Finley. It's still unclear why Green went inside, but witnesses saw his cousin dragging him out of the home. He was unable to walk because of his gunshot wound. Now, police tell us Green later died in the back of his cousin's car. Berinda Finley was shot in the leg and arm, and her son, Tamarco, was shot in the back. Now, I spoke exclusively to Berinda Finley's daughter, who was not in the home at the time, but she tells us Green and his cousins were trying to rob her family, and that home will never be the same.
We ain't gonna wanna come over here. You know, we stay on the other side of town. We not gonna wanna come over here, cause we don't know what gonna happen again, you know?
Yep.
So.
Cause maybe they try to come finish
not,
the job.
Nah, she not gonna feel comfortable staying here. Neither of them. She might be looking for somewhere else to stay.
Yeah, she's not going to feel comfortable. It's going to be hard because she probably been here for so long, you know, in this neighborhood. And it's
This is where they grew up at.
Now, Crystal Springs officers say they had to chase the Mustang these two men and Javaris Green were riding in from Crystal Springs to McGee. Now, both men are now at the Capaya County Detention Center. Chris Green is facing felony fleeing charges along with some traffic violations. Mark Green's charges are pending, but the police chief expects his investigators to file more charges next week. Now, even though the family says the men were trying to rob them, the two men that were arrested say that's not true. Tonight